can see how this bullhorn works. Yeah. Thank you guys for coming out. It's wonderful that you're out here. Thank you for speaking out for everybody in our state. You know, a society that fouls its own water doesn't last as a society very long.
Right.
And this process of fracking has too great a risk to our water supply. And what's happening now is the Republicans, I'm partisan if you hadn't noticed, the Republicans over in the House are putting through a bill that's going to turn over to the oil industry the making of rules and regulations for fracking. Well, that's the game plan.
Now,
worse than that, it's a whole herd of foxes. And so what I did the other day is offer 3 amendments. 2 of them focused on trespass. You know, the way you protect your property from somebody going on it and taking what you have is through the laws of trespass. And in places like Texas and Louisiana, those laws have been taken away as they relate to mineral rights to permit the oil companies, gas companies, to go under your property and take what belongs to you. Well, it's just simply not right. So I put in amendments to say that in whatever this oil industry crowd is going to do, that what it cannot do is take away our trespass rights, our ability to control our own property. Well, how do you think that was received?
Not well.
Well, you would really think it should have been received great. I mean, they're Republicans, right? They're about personal property rights, right? Yeah. And not only that, but they've made a big noise about it. So, and they just did legislation to prevent municipalities from involuntary annexation. The whole idea behind that is protecting individual rights in their own property, right? Right, so they all should have jumped up and gone for it. We had about 50 votes for that, I think, for the first one. But it failed. It didn't have enough. So I came back at it again. The second time, it had to do with what they do when they're testing for wells. Now, you know that most drilling for water is straight down. But fracking drilling is 51% sideways, which is how you get to somebody else's property. It's 15% directional, which is another way of saying not straight down, or another way of getting to somebody else's property. So you know you got 2/3 of the drilling going in the wrong place. So the second bill I put in was again to say you can't trespass in the test wells. Well, you'd think for sure the Republicans would support it, right? Well, some of them did. You know, the vote on that was 54-53 until the Speaker voted. And the Speaker rarely votes. And he voted against it, making it a 54-54 tie. Yeah. And for legislation to pass, it has to have half the members plus one. So if it had a tie, it failed. And that legislation failed as well. So, you know what their argument against it was? Well, they're going to come back when all of the rules are made and have the House review them. Now, folks, I've been over there long enough to tell you with confidence this thing. When study committees do bills and they come back to the House, 95% of the time they go through with little or no change. And I would give the odds of there being any change to what the oil companies do in this study against there being any change to be greater than 85% against any change. Now they're selling it on the idea that people can make changes later. Well, the possibility does exist. The probability is almost non-existent. So there's a third issue that we came up onto the floor with. A third way of attacking this. In addition to the environment, we haven't even gotten to environmental issues. We're dealing with the bill they put in at the House. And so the third way to attack it was on pooling. Now, pooling is a thing where they take your rights and they put you in a pool and they pay you what they decide to pay you for what's under your property. That, my friends, amounts to a taking of your property. It's like, it's worse than involuntary annexation, which they just did away with. Much worse. And in fact, it's very much like a thing they put in a constitutional amendment against last year. You know, sometime back there were some municipalities that were condemning private property, folks' houses, to give to a developer to do a shopping center. This was happening up in Maine. The Supreme Court said it was wrong and you can't do it. Well, we put a provision in our Constitution to say it's wrong and you can't do it. So here's the same crowd that would protect taking your property to give to a developer who's now planning on figuring out how to make the rules so they can take your property and give to a gas company. It just doesn't make any sense. And so pooling is that concept that they can put you in a crowd, give you what they decide to pay you, and you have to take it. Well, I'll tell you where it comes from and why it doesn't apply in fracking. You might want to know this for whoever you're talking with down the road. It comes from where down in Texas, folks were sticking wells in the ground and sucking out oil. Well, oil could be in a big place. And so when they were sucking it out, they came up with this legal theory called the doctrine of capture. Meaning if you can put a well in the ground and suck it out, then whatever you can get out, you get to keep regardless of where it came from. That concept doesn't apply to fracking, and the reason is you have to break up the rock to release the gas.